Then the match went out, and all that was left was the thick, cold, and damp wall. She lit another match, and suddenly she was sitting next to a beautiful Christmas tree. It was even bigger and more beautiful than the one she had seen last Christmas through the glass door in the rich merchant's house. Thousands of lights were burning on the green branches and colorful images, similar to those she had seen in the shop windows which looked down at her. The little girl stretched out both her hands toward them when the match went out. The lights of the Christmas tree rose higher and higher, and she saw them transform into bright stars in heaven. One of them fell and formed a long trail of fire. "Someone has just died," said the little girl. Her grandmother, the only person who had ever loved her and who was now not among the living, had told her that whenever a star falls, it means that a soul is ascending to God. She drew another match and lit it up. In the light glow stood her old grandmother, alive, just as mild and gentle as always. "Grandmother," cried the little girl, "take me with you. I know that you will go away when the match burns out, like the warm stove, the roast goose, and the large, beautiful Christmas tree." She quickly lit all the matches that were left in the bundle because she wanted to keep her grandmother with her. The matches glowed with a light that was brighter than that of broad daylight. Never had the grandmother been so beautiful and so grand. She took the little girl in her arms, and together they flew in brightness and joy, high, high up in the sky. There was no cold, no hunger nor fear, because they were with God now. The next morning, in the corner between the two houses, the poor little girl was sitting with red cheeks and a smile on her face. She was dead, frozen to death on the last evening of the old year. On New Year's morning, the child was sitting stiff and stark with the burnt matches in her hand. "She tried to keep warm," people said. No one knew anything about all the beautiful things she had seen and in what glory she, with her grandmother, had entered the joys of the new year. This recording of The Little Match Girl by H.C. Anderson, read to you by Grace Gordon, was presented by Yentis. Thank you for listening.